Hello, this is Christy. Very quick video today. I got a question on my YouTube channel on how to export a video to individual frames, individual images. I did a couple of videos before where you could take a bunch of images and convert them to video, but the other way around, it's very easy. And we're gonna use Shotcut today. So I'm gonna show you how to convert, export, or split a video into its own individual frames as separate JPEG files or PNG files or whatever image format you want to use. So let's have a look. So I have Shotcut here and I have version 22.06.23. They update quite frequently, so make sure you have the latest version. So I have nothing on my playlist. I'm gonna import a video from my camera, from my iPhone. It's a video that has a bunch of flowers. If I double click this video, we can play it. So as you can see, it's a very short video with some wind. So I have this video. I'm going to add it to my timeline right there. So now this is where I edit my video. Obviously, you don't have to have just this video. You could maybe have more videos or more stuff and titles and things on your timeline. And everything's going to export as an image frame, whatever you have on your timeline. So, you know, don't feel like you just have to do this video. You can have more stuff. But we're going to just use this video. Obviously, we're not going to be able to export the audio, but the video is going to be split into individual frames. So this video is about 12 seconds long. So we should have around 360, 370 images out of this at a 30 frames per second. So right now I'm in the playlist and I've got the timeline. So I can go to my timeline, go to export right here at the top. And I have the export window. And you see by default, you may have MP4 here or MOV if you're on a Mac, whatever. But I want to actually export two images. So go to this branch here where it says stock presets. Open this branch and scroll down to where you find the section called stills. Open that and you can see a bunch of image formats here. So choose what image format you want. I'm going to choose JPEG. And now you can see in the right side of this panel, things have changed and now it says format image 2. Now you still have these tabs here and it says video, codec, audio. Of course, some of this stuff is not relevant for image export, but the video, it shows you the size and it shows you how many frames per second it's going to use. Now my video is 30 frames per second. And by default here, it says 25. So if I want all of the frames exactly like in the video, I should probably just change this to 30 frames per second. So if you put more frames per second, you're gonna get more images. That's basically it. So when you're ready with these options, go to export file, choose a location on your hard drive. I made a folder here called video to image, and I'm gonna give it a name. Let's call this one flowers, okay? Shotcut's going to actually take care of adding numbers at the end of these file names for every image you export. So it's going to automatically determine how many frames it needs and it's going to make those numbers padded. So you're going to have 00001, for example, for your frame one, and it's going to be, you know, padded with zeros. So the file names are always the same length. So it says here JPEG and I'm ready to go. So you should see the export progress now. Here we go. So now the images have been saved. I did this before, as you can see, just to test. So I'm going to go inside of that folder. Let's find it. So this is the folder with the flowers. You can see the file names, flowers 00001, 02, 3, and so on. And if we go down all the way to the end, we can see 377 frames total. So if I open one of these files, let's open the first one. It opens in my photo viewer, which happens to be XN view. So I'm going to use the page down key to go through the files. And you can see as I go, the individual frames show up. So there you have it. This is how you export a video to images, individual frames, in JPEG format. You could have chosen PNG or whatever other format you want. Doesn't make any difference. So I hope this was useful. Thank you for watching, and let me know in the comments what you thought. And if you use another software to create the same effect to export individual frames, let me know in the comments which one it is. So thanks again, and see you on the next one.